Hi everybody, Miss Saha here in the kitchen. I've been fooling around today with homemade Play-Doh recipes, and I think I found one that actually works and doesn't need expensive or hard to find ingredients like cream of tartar, like many of the recipes you may have seen online. I'll show you what I used, and then I'll share the recipe with you, and we can have some fun coloring our Play-Doh together today. So this recipe uses a few simple ingredients that you may have at home. It uses flour, it uses salt, it uses oil, just a bit of oil, water, and the interesting ingredient that replaces cream of tartar, which, although it's called cream, is a powder. It's found in the baking section. And yes, the best recipes do use cream of tartar, but I found a substitute that uses lemon juice. Apparently there's something chemical about lemon juice that that gives the elasticity or the flex to your dough. And so that's what intrigued me about this recipe, because I don't have cream of tartar, and I don't want to make a special grocery trip. So this is a cook recipe. So even though kids are great measurers, I do recommend getting an adult to do the pan cooking. And once it is in its ball form, then the kids can get back involved. So I'm going to break it up into a few balls. And I will lower the camera so that we can see the food coloring together. Let's move that water out of the way. Move the flour out of the way. All right, I've got a few colors here. And if you have gloves at home, you can wear gloves, or because no one is going to be seeing my hands for a while, I'm not going to worry about it for this video. I'm going to get some blue going there. Whoa, I might want to rethink those gloves. The dough is kneading really well. Kneading is this, what you see me doing now, of I'm going to put a bit more flour on my surface here. I washed this tray and it's still a bit damp. So you can see how long it is taking to really get the blue mixed in there. But it's working, and this dough is holding together nicely. It's flexing nicely. It's not falling apart in my hand. I'm really happy with it. What color should we make next? Let's see what this chartreuse green looks like. Chartreuse is a kind of green that is halfway between yellow and green. It's a yellowy green, and it's one of my favorite colors. See how I'm using the heel of my hand to mix that in? Wow, I'm so happy with the consistency of this Play-Doh. Let's make, I don't know if this is gonna be as red as it looks. The cap on that one looks a bit orange. Uh-oh, SpaghettiOs. Miss Saha maybe should have worn gloves. That's okay. They're only hands, and I can wash them. So parents, if you're the ones watching this, given the transfer of color to my hands, you may want to have your kids watch this and be the one to do the initial adding of food coloring with gloves. It does not seem to transfer once it's all mixed in. Look at that. So playing with the finished dough will not color your hands. It's the making of the dough that colors your hands, it seems. So here's purple, is my last one. Wow. Good thing I'm not doing this straight on my counter. So the recipe that I'm including for you, one recipe made this much dough. You don't need to double it to get four small balls of Play-Doh that you can make into different colors. It does take some work and some patience though, doesn't it? Oh, the consistency is just great. Now, to save your Play-Doh, you will need plastic wrap or an old Play-Doh container would be perfect, wouldn't it? I think I have some of those around. Or a bowl with a lid to seal them up tight. Let's get rid of this tray. And the lemon. And I'll show you some great things that you can do with your child. Pick up some of this flour. With your child, now that you have this or any Play-Doh. Everybody knows how to make Play-Doh snakes, right? Here we go. We're going to make some Play-Doh snakes. Now, why do you think the librarian likes Play-Doh so much? I'll tell you. Play-Doh is one of my favorite ways to make letters. When you have some really great, super long Play-Doh snakes, we're going to make some letters of the alphabet. We're even going to spell your name. Now, if your name's Isabella or something with a lot of letters, this is going to take you a long time. So let's just practice making a few letters. So say I was going to make an I for Izzy. I would make the main stick of the I because Isabella starts with a capital. I'm going to put my top and my bottom on. And when you're making letters with your kids, you can talk about them and whether they have curves or straight lines. Maybe I'll try to make Saha. Let me see if I can make it upside down for you. Well, there's my S. Let's make my A. So I need two long straight parts and a little stick in the middle. I'm going to make my H. Oh, look at that. The part that broke off is perfect for my H. And what do I need next to finish the name Saha? That's right. I need one more A. So I better roll this chartreuse Play-Doh out a little bit thinner. Look at that. How one piece is going to make both the long sides of my A. And then I'll break off another little piece. S-A-H-A. Saha, I did it. I hope you have all kinds of fun with dough today. I hope you give this recipe a try. I really give it 5 stars. Let me pop back up here so I can see you. You know, not every recipe works out the way you expect it. And this one really did. So it seemed like lemon is a cheap and easily available substitute for cream of tartar in homemade Play-Doh recipes. And this one gets my best reco. I hope you do it. And I'll see you here soon again with more great ideas from home. Bye for now.